Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer. Have you ever wondered how to make a contour map? Well, you're in the right place. Let's learn how to make a contour map. Well, so to begin, we're going to need to look at some data. So as you can see, we have our station data, we have backsight, height of instrument, the foresight. We also have our distances, elevations, bearings, and remarks. Now this data has already been solved for us, so we don't really have to worry too much about trying to get the numbers. As you can see, we have our distance and our bearing, which are going to be the two values that will be most important for our map. Now looking back at the map, this little red dot, that's where our auto level or station would be, and we would be able to look at the bearing based in direction of where we were looking and define our marker or our stations. So what we're going to need to do is first, by looking at the bearing and the distance, we can actually interpret how we're going to draw this on the map. Now notice the scale on this map, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 meters. So we're able to look at our data and see that we're looking at a 20 meter, which is the same as 10 centimeters. Or the one below it, 22 meters, which is going to be the same as 11 centimeters. And we're going to be able to use those numbers to help plot this. So the first step we're going to need is to center our protractor on that red dot. Notice that as I'm centering it, we can locate where the 90, which is marked on the table, and the 180 is. The next thing we're going to do is look for station 1 and the bearing, which is 99 degrees. So I mark 99 degrees on the paper using the protractor. Now I'm able to remove the protractor and bring in my ruler. So I'm going to center at that little dot where our station was and measure out along that dot to the 10 centimeter mark. Remember, because it's 20 meters, or in the scale, 10 centimeters. And I put a dot there. And now I'm going to make it a little darker and put number 1. That will be station number 1. Excellent. So let's do it again. This time we'll look at station 2. I see that the bearing is 107 degrees. I line up my protractor again, 90 to 180, and then I mark where 107 would be on the protractor's paper. Then from there, I take my ruler, center it again. I see that this time it's going to be at 11 centimeters away. Center, mark it on the paper at 11. Remove my ruler. I'm going to make it a little darker and put a number 2. That's going to be station number 2. And now I can connect the dots. So let's do one more. Station number 3. I can see that it has a bearing of 111 degrees. So I mark 111. I see that the distance is 24, which will be 12 centimeters. On our scale map, again, lining up my ruler along that mark I made with the protractor and marking at 12 centimeters. I'll make that dot a little darker and add a number 3, which will be station number 3, and I will connect the dot. Well, something to point out is notice that all of these stations here have the same elevation. So what I'm literally drawing is one singular contour line, because they all have the same elevation. So what's important, we have 16 stations. We're going to be able to draw a continuous contour line on our map. Why? Well, because we have data. We have the distance from which those stations were from our auto level and the bearing. Between those two, we're going to be able to easily draw our map. I hope that this was helpful. If you have any questions, be sure to comment below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and we'll talk soon.